A mysterious man enters a house and clashes with a series of attackers, killing them all but their leader who escapes. He is informed of a new mission, which involves determining whether the noble daughter of the angel family Melita Angel truly possesses mana under the guise of being her tutor. The angel family, well known for producing top-class paladin-level children, refuses to be dishonored if Melita ends up being the product of an affair with a commoner and as a result has no mana, hoping to assassinate her if so. Under the false name of Kufa Vampire, the man puts on a kind persona which causes Melita to immediately taking a liking to him. Kufa notices despite the disdain received from her peers, teachers and grandfather, as well as her own jealousy towards her paladin class cousin Elise, Melita persists a strong and hard-working spirit. Rigorously practicing her swordsmanship and attempting to practice independently slaughtering evil lycanthropes, creatures of the night lurk outside the final human city of Flandor, her grandfather Lord Mordred lures in to pressure her into awakening her mana. Although Kufa concludes she is an illegitimate child and by his guild White Knight's order, has to kill her, instead he introduces her to risky method of awakening her mana, feeding the potion to her with a kiss. Melita collapses but awakes the next day with the newfound ability to use mana. Kufa warns Melita should anyone know about the potion, the both of them will be executed, as she has taken mana in this method. Her class is not a paladin but a samurai like him, looking forward to the moment when she will be acknowledged after all her struggles. Kufa requests she keeps her awakening a secret until the academy's end of semester tournament exam. At the academy, they are approached by Elise and her own private tutor, Rossetti Prickett, a member of the powerful guild Crest Legion and a maiden-class warrior famed for her skills. Rossetti, smitten with Kufa, attempts to make a move, but his rejection prompts her to vow Elise will defeat Melita during the tournament. With the tournament held in teams, Melita is accepted into one out of pity and ends up against her nemesis and bully Nerva Martillo's team. Surprising everyone with her mana abilities and quick reflexes, Melita corners the gladiator class Nerva and manages to defeat her despite running out of mana halfway by copying one of Kufa's abilities, impressing him greatly. Nerva apologizes sincerely to Melita after the latter's win in the tournament, moving on to compete against Elise's team, only for Elise to win single-handedly. Melita asks Kufa out to the upcoming school festival circlet night, but he declines, feeling apologetic for lashing out at Elise before when they used to be so close as children. Melita decides to wear a special dress they had promised to match together but is disheartened to see Elise forced to wear something fancier on her family's orders. She realizes they both have been suffering in loneliness all this while, determined by their respective classes, ashamed of being unable to keep her promise. Elise runs away with Melita in pursuit, but they are kidnapped by lycanthropes and brought to an abandoned museum where their leader, a half-lycanthrope named William Jin and also the man Kufa failed to kill, awaits. Jin informs he was ordered to transfer Elise's mana to Melita and turn her into a paladin. Although the two girls almost manage to escape, they are eventually cornered. Fortunately, they are saved by their tutors. Kufa and Jin begin a showdown, revealing Kufa's identity to be a half-vampire, the strongest kind of lycanthrope. Kufa severely injures Jin, sparing him only to return to his superiors with a warning. Back at the festival, Kufa asks Melita for a dance and she asks him to stay by her side forever. Elsewhere, Kufa's guild are concerned he has gone rogue and orders a mage called Black Madia to investigate. In a flashback, Elise remembers Melita protecting her from a lycanthrope wolf while they were lost in the forest. With the new semester, the principal announces the annual tournament between St. Friedsuite and the St. Deatrich Girls Academy called the Luna Lumiere Selection. Much to the shock of the staff and students, Melita and Elise are chosen, with Melita choosing Nerva and a girl named Shinfat Svito to join her team. While resting from training, Melita also encounters a mysterious mule lawnmower from St. Deatrich, who encourages her. Kufa catches a maid from Elise's household trying to leave, revealing she had rigged the name selection to sabotage the girl's relationship. However, Melita seeks her approval instead and challenges the maid if she wins the tournament, she will form a unit with Elise. Kufa finally encounters Black Madia, who asks him to bring a sample of Melita's blood for closer examination and to prove his loyalty to the guild. Kufa refuses and the two begin to fight. but he is outmatched by Black Madia, whose clown class lets her mimic the abilities of other classes, until Rossetti joins in. Meanwhile, Elise suggests losing to Mulita on purpose so they can form a unit together. 3 days before the Luna Lumiere selection tournament begins, Kufa and Rossetti ask the academy principal to suspend the event until they find Black Madia, but they are refused. At lunch, Mulita appears to eat alone when Rossetti comes up to Elise and asks her about if something happened between them. Nerva and Shinfaw sit next to Mulita and begin to discuss a strategy the tournament. The night before it starts, Kufa asks Mulita about her issues with Elise, and she reveals Elise's decision to lose on purpose. Kufa suggests to Mulita to talk to her alone and sort it out as siblings. At the beginning of the tournament, Nerva and Shinfaw fends off attacks from Elise's teammates, allowing Mulita to fight Elise alone. Meanwhile, Kufa finds a suspicious girl alone at the top of a school tower observing the battle below. Thinking she is Black Madia, he attacks her, but is surprisingly fended off by her Diablo class. He then asks her name and apologizes when she reveals herself as Neil Lawmore, a member of one of the three Night Duke houses. As Black Madia can only imitate the abilities of lower ranked classes, it can't be her. Mulita and Elise fight until Mulita catches Elise by surprise and knocks her out of the fight, resigning herself from the tournament. Nerva approaches them and Mulita realizes Nerva was an imposter with different mana and she reveals she's Black Madia in disguise. Kufa and Rossetti confront Black Madia and defeat her. Kufa transports her outside of the academy and gives her a letter to Father on Mulita's growth. Later, Kira Espada from St. Deotrish is revealed to have won the tournament. Mulita confronts Elise about wanting to form a unit and she happily agrees. Kufa knows he's missing something as a non-mana wielder, like the old maid cannot enter the glass palace to change the stained glass unless someone helped her in. At night, Rossetti approaches Kufa about a possible rumor among the students. Meanwhile, Mulita, Elise, Mule, and Salacha sneak out and travel through a tunnel to meet the rest of their classmates in secret. Shinfaw toasts a party to everyone from St. Friedsweed and St. Deotrish for a completed tournament. Afterwards, while everyone cheerfully enjoys the party, Mule tells them an old story about a married couple and whose marriage soured to the point where the husband killed his wife and cut out her heart. Salacha then chimes in and says the woman, now known as the Grey Witch, still wanders the earth and cuts the hearts out of young girls, scaring Elise and Mulita. Suddenly the lights go out and a shadow of a woman with red mana stands in the doorway. Mulita, thinking it is the girl from the story, asks if the shadow is the Grey Witch, only for the woman to smirk. Terrified, Mulita, Elise, Mule, and Salacha flee from the room as the witch begins to wreak havoc. They head back through the tunnel until they come across unknown sticky, pink blobs of goo covering them. They continue to run until they are blocked at the exit by the witch. They decide to fight their way out, but are easily defeated and turn to run away. They manage to find their way out and see Kufa out on watch duty, but are horrified when they believe his heart was cut out. Kufa brings them back to the dorm and explains how he found out about the secret party from Rossetti and decided to play along with her scheme of portraying the Grey Witch. He lectures the girls for breaking curfew and to go back to their rooms, but they end up too exhausted from the ordeal and share a bed for the night. Mulita awakens from a nightmare to Kufa telling her to get ready for a school field trip to Shangarda, one of the only human settlements outside Flandor. As they get to the academy, Rossetti runs up and proposes to Kufa to take her as his fiancée in order to trick her father, Marquis Blossom Prickett, who has already handpicked someone for her. Kufa agrees, much to Melita's chagrin. Once Blossom arrives, he brings up the idea to perform the wedding ceremony in Shangarda, the destination of the field trip and Rossetti's hometown, but Rossetti says she's happy with her current fiancé. Blossom studies Kufa closely and is reminded of a serial killer from Rossetti's youth who is supposedly dead, though Rossetti doesn't remember it. Concerned, Mulita ditches class and runs to ask Kufa about this, but runs into Black Madia, now known as Lack. Mulita begins hearing a voice in her head, but they're interrupted by a scream from down the hall and come across an unconscious student. Blossom uses a potion to determine the perpetrator is a male who uses blue-colored mana, causing many to suspect Kufa. Later, the students arrive in Shangarda, where Mulita hears more voices and wanders off towards some suspicious plants. Blossom stops her and explains the area is home to many dangerous mystery spots. Someone then informs Blossom about a sick resident who has to be killed in order to stop the illness. Rossetti brings Kufa to a church where she apologizes for asking him to be her fiancé, but thanks him for going along with the idea. As Kufa returns to Molita's dorm, she is upset at him being so late and demands something in return. Kufa takes her out and shows her a mystery spot he found a long time ago. They arrive at a magnetic cave where they're able to float around the cavern, much to Molita's joy. At night, Molita has another nightmare with a strange voice and is woken up by Elise, who tells her of another attack by the Blue Mana perpetrator, and Kufa is nowhere to be found. Molita and Elise arrive at the scene to find all of Blossom's adopted children drained of life energy. Blossom suspects Kufa committed the crime and told the town citizens to find him. Molita runs off in search of Kufa, but Lack stops her and agrees to help solve the mystery. In order to maintain a low profile, Lack disguises herself as a student, and the duo wander around town asking the citizens for any knowledge regarding the mystery spots. After cunningly getting information from a woman in a flower shop, Molita and Lack find the Crooked House, an abandoned house which is rumored to be the most dangerous mystery spot. They discover a pathway leading underground and follow it, leading them to a dungeon which has been filled with the corpses of the townspeople who were killed for harboring the strange sickness. As Lack begins to suspect Blossom of experimenting on the townsfolk, Molita hears the voice in her head and runs off, suspecting another incident is about to occur. She rushes to the church and finds Elise unconscious and Rossetti dead. The citizens head out to find Kufa while Blossom takes Rossetti's body himself. As Molita lays Elise down to rest, Shinfa runs in and tells Molita Blossom has been attacked and Rossetti's body taken, as well as the residents are coming for Molita due to her connection to Kufa. She escapes and runs to the mystery spot where Blossom warned about the plants and broke through a wall leading into a tunnel. She follows it and comes across an underground library. She picks up the files and reads them, discovering how Blossom has been tampering with lycanthropes and humans with the night gene factor. She then hears same voice in her head, and suddenly Rossetti appears with white hair and blue mana. The voice then orders Rossetti to attack, but Kufa appears and stops her. As the two clash, Kufa transforms into his vampire form, causing Rossetti to flee and Molita to gaze at him in horror. Molita attempts to approach Kufa, but he pins her down and says he will erase her memories of him back to the day they met. Molita kisses Kufa, saying no matter what, she will stand by his side. Kufa then reveals he is half lycanthrope to Molita and explains how he was one of Blossom's experimental children in Shangarda. He was a successful mixture of human and lycanthrope, but when an enormous spider-like lycanthrope named Nakwa attacked the town, he and Father from the White Knights worked together to defeat it. However, Rossetti was injured, forcing Kufa to turn her into a vampire to save her life and freeze her memories so she forgot she was a vampire. He wanted her to be happy without the burden of knowing what she is before joining Father's Guild. Kufa asks Molita to keep what she just heard a secret before explaining Nakwa has somehow returned and teamed up with Blossom to get Rossetti a fiancé and increase the number of mana users in Shangarda. Kufa says that he already has a plan and requires some assistance. Molita barges into the chapel where Rossetti is getting married and says her love for Kufa is stronger than Rossetti's, snapping the latter out of her daze. The two get into a fight, causing Nakwa to reveal himself as the perpetrator of the attacks thus far. Nakwa escapes with Rossetti giving chase, who remembers everything about her past. Kufa arrives and both he and Rossetti change into vampire form to engage in combat with Nakwa. With the help of the academy students, they're able to defeat Nakwa once and for all. Rossetti happily remembers her past, but Kufa freezes her memories again due to the pact he made with the guild. Kufa finds Blossom in a dark room with his wife Carmilla pinned to a wall, who is in the process of becoming a lycanthrope. To repay his debt to Blossom for raising him, Kufa gives Carmilla a drug to turn her back into a human. As the students return home, Blossom is revealed to have turned himself in, while Molita welcomes Elise back and teases Rossetti about her new relationship with Kufa. Due to their excelling academics and training, Molita and Elise are invited by the headmistress to participate in the upcoming Vibria Goat Librarian Certification Exam. Meanwhile, a secret gathering of nobles led by Salacha's brother, Sir Chicksal, have deduced Mulita might be an illegitimate child and plan on testing this during the exam on Mule Longmore's proposal. On the day of the exam, Kufa is called by Mulita's father, Felgus Angel, who wishes to take her back home following an incident where an unknown masked man appeared at the school and claimed to be her biological father, hoping to spread rumors. Kufa attempts to dissuade him when they are notified that the exam is being targeted by the criminal guild Grimfis. Elsewhere, the students attending the exam are attacked, separating Mulita and Elise from the others. They then end up fighting a group of ghosts acting as the dungeon's guardians, but are saved by Salacha and Mule. Kufa reassures Rossetti that he will deal with Guild Grimfis targeting the students and tells her to stay behind to protect the other students. Mule explains to Mulita and Elise about them taking the exam too and offers for them to join as a team. Afterwards, the group approaches a disheveled bookshelf that needs to be rearranged in the correct order. When they reach down to pick up a book, small imps appear as their foes. Mulita defeats them and Mule tells Elise and Salacha to place the books back to the correct bookshelf. After the books are in place, they are given special books that indicate they passed the exam, but Salacha suddenly takes Mulita's book away. Meanwhile, the headmistress attempts to regroup with the other students, but is attacked by Grimfis members and is injured. Kufa appears and defeats the enemies while one of the guild executives summons more ghosts. Mule then takes the book from Salacha, reads out loud that Mulita's class is samurai, before attempting to escape the labyrinth. As Kufa begins to become surrounded by ghosts, Jin appears and defeats the remaining enemies, before revealing that Grimfis isn't after Mulita, but the entire student body of the academy. Father suddenly appears, recruiting Jin to his services in exchange for the formula to turn lycanthropes back to humans. Father then charges Kufa with finding the missing girls and bring them back safely. Meanwhile, Mulita catches Mule and demands an explanation, but is met with a spell and is surrounded by bright light. Mulita awakens in a courtroom akin to the Queen of Hearts from Alice in Wonderland, which is run by Mule, Serge, and the other noble families of Flandor as the jury. Serge accuses Mulita of deceiving everyone by being an illegitimate child of the angel family, causing the jury to stir and throw insults at her. She retorts that she is the heir of the angel family and will prove it by getting strong enough to join the Crest Legion. Serge accepts the challenge and invites Mulita to fight Salacha to prove her worth. After initially getting cornered by Salacha's dragoon class, Mulita uses Kufa's training and feints falling off balance to catch Salacha off guard, defeating her. The jury begins to doubt their accusations and worry about the consequences of their actions, until Serge suddenly reveals a magical pen that transforms into a massive ink-like dragon. As the girls evacuate the nobles, Serge is revealed to be a member of Guild Grimfis in disguise, who also claimed to be Mulita's biological father. As he attacks the girls, Kufa appears and fends off the attack, allowing he and Mulita to work together to defeat the masked man. The man wakes up in the real world beside Serge, who laments their foiled plans and kills the man for failing. A few days later, the culprit was revealed to be a disgraced member of the Crest Legion, Felgus. Mulita's father arrives soon after to investigate the current status of the Legion, and later tells Mulita that a distant relative of theirs was samurai class. He decides Mulita happened to be born samurai instead of paladin class, but still acknowledges her as his daughter. Sometime later, Mulita meets with Kufa and promises to be able to protect him someday, reinforcing his decision to be with her. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.